Ahem. I do apologize for keeping you waiting. Now then, let's resume the class trial. We've all just learned of the shocking revelation that Chihiro was actually a boy. Let's pick up from there.
Yes, well, I don't know his reason for hiding it, but the fact is, Chihiro was not a girl, but a boy.
Okay, I mean, living in the culture I do, I would assume that Chihiro was transgendered, but that I guess that may not be the case, seeing as how this is Japanese culture. To think that Chihiro was actually a guy. The thought had never even crossed my mind.
And because the victim was male, he would have had no problem gaining access to the boys' locker room.
Assuming his handbook did, in fact, list his gender as male, then yes, that would be true.
Of course his handbook said he was a boy. He dressed like a girl, but he was a boy through and through.
So are you saying that in the physical sense, or are you saying that Chihiro wasn't actually gender identifying as a girl?
So then, there should be no issue with Makoto's initial assertion. The victim was killed in the boys' locker room, and was then later moved to the girls' locker room. And the killer could have easily used Sayaka or Junko's handbook to get into the girls' locker room.
Right.
So, Chihiro really was killed in the boys' locker room?
It's what it seems like, yes.
I still don't understand the motive for moving the body, but yes, that does seem plausible.
It was to try to throw off our suspicions that a guy killed her.
Well, I must admit, I did find it rather odd.
And you're sweating still.
I knew he felt a little off. There was a certain incongruity to his female body.
Okay.
This is a most titillating situation!
So Byakuya's admitting to having messed with the body, because he said it felt incongruous.
So now everything has been connected. All the mysteries have finally become clear.
Except for the whole arrangement thing.
Okay, well,
and how you knew about it
clear
beforehand.
Whatever. We still think you're the killer, remember?
Very interesting. This has become very interesting indeed.
Surely, he's not doing this just to make it more exciting. That would be very idiotic.
Ah, he's off in his own little world.
What about you, Makoto? After everything we've learned, do you still think Byakuya's the killer?
I'm kinda up in the air. At this point, I'm leaning towards no, but I do think that he had something either to do with arranging the body, or he had previously discovered it. I'm not sure.
Well, without a doubt, Byakuya is the one that made Chihiro's death look like Genocide Jack did it.
Okay.
But I...
Have we proven that? I mean...
I think he might not actually be the killer after all.
Yeah, might not.
What? But aren't you the one who accused him in the first place?
I mean, we followed the evidence we had.
He just seems to be too easygoing about all this. Like he's enjoying us solving the mystery.
I don't know that that's evidence. I mean, he could just be that good at acting.
The way he's acting, it makes it seem like it doesn't have anything to do with him.
And you think that might be because it doesn't have anything to do with him?
I mean, it could be.
Plus, the evidence he left behind was a little too, how can I put it, overt.
That's a very good word.
He consciously chose to use the extension cord, knowing it could connect him to the murder. At least, that's how I see it. And Byakuya, when you found out the murder took place in the boys' locker room, it seemed to rattle you.
Yeah, like he didn't know about that.
And then again, when you found out Chihiro was actually a guy.
Mm-hmm.
If you really were the killer, that stuff wouldn't have had any effect on you.
Except it could all just be a very good act.
So that's your thinking, huh? Well, it bothers me that you don't have more concrete reasons, but it's fine. I guess I'll mark it as correct for the time being.
Thank you so much, Your Lordship.
Mark it as correct?
He's right. I am not the culprit.
I mean, we can't just take your word for it, but...
I just happened to come across the corpse in the girls' locker room and decided to alter it.
Are you fucking with us right now?
Maybe. I mean, that's all he's been doing so far, this whole investigation and trial.
No, I am not effing with you right now. I'm telling you the truth.
I don't understand why Byakuya had a problem with saying fucking. But whatever, to each their own.
Well, I find it very hard to believe.
Don't cry about it, Taka.
Go ahead. Find it very hard to believe. You're free to be executed along with the rest of us.
Yeah, which is why I don't understand why you would do this. Because it makes us much more likely to get this all wrong.
If you're really telling the truth, then why? Why do you do that to his body?
My reasons hardly matter right now. Uncovering the culprit is much more important, wouldn't you say?
I would, except you've put very large roadblocks in the way, Byakuya.
Now then, if it wasn't me, who was it?
Well, I don't think I can say for sure without talking about it a little more.
Can we mark Toko and Byakuya off the list decisively? I'm still not sure. I think we can, but I don't want to say for certain that we can.
We're seriously gonna keep going? We're all good, aren't we? I thought it was clear Byakuya did it.
So at least for my suspect list, we have Mondo and Celeste, but it could just be someone else that I've not considered at all.
No, I'm with Makoto. If there's any doubt whatsoever, we need to explore every possibility. Because if we're wrong, we all die here.
Well, except for the killer.
That's true. Very well then. I'm with you too.
Yes, we need to take as much time as necessary to get this right. Or at least as much time as Monokuma allows us to take.
Damn straight. Count me in.
Do you not have a mind of your own?
Not much of one.
Of course I do. What am I, an ant or something?
No comment.
Anyway, let's discuss this all as a group one more time. We still have time to make our decision.
That's very true.
Our lives are all on the line.
Excellent. Then shall we resume our game of hide and seek?
But if Byakuya didn't do it, then who's the real killer? Who murdered Chihiro? There's one thing we can be sure that we know about the killer. The killer was able to gain access to the real murder scene, which means... presumably it means it's a guy, but again, there's the notebook thing in the mailbox, so it could still be a girl, and that broken notebook could be a female notebook, and they could have Leon's. But since we don't have that choice...
I got it!
Since the crime scene was the boys' locker room, you would need a boy's handbook to get in. There's still the loophole as well. Since Leon's handbook is apparently broken, the killer would have had to use their own, or borrow one from the mailbox, or steal, borrow Leon's and replace it with their broken one, or steal one from another classmate. In other words, it had to have been a guy. I think that's faulty logic at this point, but we'll go with it. But that's still not enough. I need to find some more clues. All right. Celeste's account. About Chihiro
Isn't
going
there
to exercise.
A single clue that might lead us to who did it?
Well, clues are one thing, but did nobody get a look at the killer?
No.
Sure, if someone saw the killer, they would have said something by now.
Hopefully.
Perhaps someone saw the victim at some point.
Yes, they did.
Even that might be enough for now.
Are you going to speak up, Celeste?
All we need right now is any kind of new info.
Okay, here's the new info. Oh. Well, I guess I should have gone on. I guess I'm losing a heart.
Shoot!
Yep. Sorry.
Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to...
Well, did nobody get... I'm sure if someone saw the...
Perhaps someone saw the victim at some...
Yeah. All we need right now is any kind of new info.
It's over. It's all over.
Oh, cheer
you
up.
You wanna know who saw the victim? The killer! And only the killer!
Okay, that's probably what we
and
need to shoot,
like
but I'm gonna go through
gonna
the whole thing.
Turn themselves in! Game over, man! Game over!
Yeah! No! Not game over!
Okay, we need to shoot Hiro's statement. No, as a matter of fact, there is an eyewitness account regarding Chihiro, and I wonder why she's not just stepping forward herself. She has more information about that.
Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to who did it?
Well, clues are one thing.
But did nobody get... I'm sure if someone saw the...
Perhaps someone saw the victim.
Yeah.
All right, come on.
It's over. It's all over. You want to know who saw the victim? The killer.
Nope.
And only the...
No, that's wrong. I believe someone else did see the victim before he was murdered. What do you think, Celeste?
Mm-hmm.
Now that you mention it, yes, I did see him.
What, you needed us to jog your memory?
Huh? Really?
Oh, but I suppose only Makoto knows about this.
That's a very interesting pronunciation of Makoto's name.
The rest of you had no idea, did you? That is why you're all making such ugly noises.
Whatever! Just hurry up and tell us!
Please?
It was last night, right before nighttime. I saw Chihiro in the dormitory warehouse. I saw him stuffing a track jacket into a duffel bag. And then, I assume, he headed off to exercise.
A track jacket and a duffel bag? But we didn't find anything like that at the murder scene.
I know.
It seems likely that the culprit destroyed them to get rid of any evidence.
Or hid them somewhere.
And that is when he said something that struck me as rather odd.
Well, I better get going. I'm kind of in a hurry.
Chihiro told me he was in a hurry.
And why would she be in a hurry? Unless they were meeting someone.
But why would he be in a hurry? Only if someone were waiting for him, I should think.
Yeah.
So Mr. Fujisaki was on his way to meet with someone, and then they were going to work out together?
But Hina and I had invited him to exercise with us plenty of times, and he always declined.
So are we referring to Chihiro as he now? I'm still not certain about that.
Probably because he was afraid you'd find out the secret he was hiding, right?
Which means that conversely, he must have trusted whoever he was meeting with very much.
And who would Chihiro trust very much?
Enough so that he was willing to risk his secret being revealed.
Oh, what a marvelous friendship!
Well, apparently not, since it got Chihiro killed.
The point is, whoever he met up with is the culprit, right? So we just gotta figure out who it was.
But knowing what we know, I can't even guess.
No. You already have what you need to make the connection.
Okay.
Huh?
You know who the killer is.
Seriously? Who is it? Who's the killer?
It's fucking Mondo. That's who it is. It's Mondo. He knew Chihiro was a guy. I'd forgotten about that. He knew Chihiro was biologically male, and he's sweating bullets right now. It was Mondo. God damn it, Mondo.
Think back to the track jacket and duffel bag the killer disposed of. Focus on the details of these items, and it should become obvious who was waiting for him.
I don't... Really?
Are you sure about that? you really think we can figure out who did it based on two pieces of evidence that we don't have?
What? You want to track down some fingerprints or something?
Even if we had the equipment for that, we wouldn't know how to use it.
As was noted, the evidence is already gone. There's nothing to get fingerprints from.
We could search for it, I guess?
Maybe, but we can make certain inferences if we just take the time to talk it out.
Easy for you to say. But fine. Celeste, did you notice anything special about the bag or jacket?
The bag was just a normal duffel bag from the warehouse. All the bags in there are the same, so I can't imagine what would make that one special.
Well, if I remember right, there was a decent variety of tracksuits to choose from. Do you think there might be some connection between the culprit and Chihiro's jacket?
Maybe?
Perhaps. Let's explore that and talk a bit more about the jacket he took.
Does Chihiro's track jacket really hold some clue about the killer? Somehow, it's really hard to believe. Celeste's account. Okay.
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed.
Yes.
He was on his way to go exercise.
This time I'm going to let it all go through.
So next we have to ask, why did he choose the specific tracksuit that he did?
What do you mean, the specific tracksuit?
I got it! He picked that tracksuit because it matched the one the culprit was wearing!
So, what you're saying is, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him? My tracksuit is black!
How did you know it was blue?
I don't even have a tracksuit. Cause exercising sucks!
We didn't say the tracksuit was blue, Mondo.
Personally. I got it from the warehouse, if you must know.
Did any of that really help us get any closer to figuring out who the culprit
is? It did. It did.
No way. Not a chance.
You heard him, right? What he just said without even realizing it?
Yep. You were making a gambit. You're lucky it worked out because in discussing the tracksuit and duffel bag, Celeste could have easily said what color that it was. She's right. What he said just now was really odd. How did he know something like that?
First of all, we know where Chihiro was.
He was on his way. So next week, why did he choose?
What do you mean?
I got it! He picked that. It matched the one the culprit was wearing.
All right, here we go.
So what you're saying is, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit?
No, that's wrong.
I'm so disappointed in you, Mondo.
Hold on a second, Mondo. What did you just say?
You were actually really, really close to just coming off my suspect list.
Huh? What'd I say?
When Celeste testified a few minutes ago, she said...
I saw him stuffing a track jacket into a duffel bag. And then I assumed he headed off to exercise.
She never said anything about the jacket's color. So why did you say Chihiro's blue tracksuit?
What are you? You just...
No, you just.
Hey, Celeste, what color was Chihiro's tracksuit?
As a matter of fact, it was blue.
And before we began the trial, did you tell anyone that?
Just you.
The only one I told about any of this was you.
Then, Mondo, how did you know what color Chihiro's tracksuit was?
Because he saw it.
But because I just... I'm sure he saw the clothes at some point in the investigation.
Oh, I'm sorry, Taka. I'd almost forgotten that you two were bros now.
No, that can't be it. The bag and clothes were surely disposed of by the time we began our investigation.
Then the only reason he could have known what color the tracksuit was is if he saw Cherry with it before he died! That's the only possibility!
Cherry? Are...
Are you talking about Chihiro?
So, how about it? Did you see the tracksuit or didn't you?
He did.
Just by chance. I just happened to see it last night.
How?
He walked past me, and he was carrying the tracksuit in his hands.
No, Celeste said that he stuffed the little hanging out sleeve into the duffel bag.
No, that can't be it either. According to Celeste's testimony,
she stuffed the jacket into her bag in a hurry. It was almost like she was trying to hide it. And just like that, she was gone.
When Celeste noticed it, Chihiro made a point of making sure the jacket was completely in the bag. If you just ran into him briefly, you couldn't possibly have seen what color the tracksuit was.
Yeah.
It would appear you've dug your own grave.
Perhaps. But you handed him the shovel, didn't you? That's why you said what you did.
That's exactly why.
Focus on the tracksuit and it'll be obvious who he met with? What a bunch of nonsense.
And as I said, it was very risky. Celeste could have let slip the color before Mondo said anything. Very easily.
Ah, now I understand. It was all one big bluff, wasn't it? Your true intention was to draw a slip of the tongue from the culprit. That's why you said you knew who did it, to put them on edge.
That's right. However, Mondo was my target all along. I had my suspicions about him from the very beginning.
Because he referred to Chihiro as dude.
But why? What made...
That's a good question. There was a certain turning point that tipped me off. Maybe you didn't notice it, Mondo, but you tend to refer to men and women differently.
He does indeed.
You only call guys dude. For girls, it's chick. And after he was killed, you happened to refer to him as dude. Once I picked up on that, it occurred to me that Mondo knew something we didn't.
You notice such a tiny detail?
Are you a witch? She's a witch! You're positively frightful!
No, I'm not the frightful one.
No, unfortunately in this case, it's Mondo.
Not nearly as frightful as someone capable of murdering a friend.
Someone who had placed their trust in him.
Mondo, was it really you?
And I'm wondering whether it was a murder to prevent his secret from leaking out, or because of some prejudice towards people like Chihiro.
Did you really kill Chihiro?
Yes?
I didn't kill anyone!
Yeah, I don't believe you.
You've been all over me, judging everything I say, putting words in my mouth.
No, you spoke your own words.
What gives you the right to treat me like a goddamn criminal?
Because you are one.
Yeah, he would never do something like that. This is a false accusation.
I'm sorry, Taka, but you're gonna have to see reason here.
It's true. My reasoning on that is pretty shaky.
That was fast.
Well, this does present us with a problem. It seems we are all out of leads.
There has to be something more.
My time has nearly come.
Oh, that's right. You were holding back evidence, weren't you, Hifumi? Is it actually relevant evidence? If so, please share it with the class.
That's what my little ghost friend is telling me.
Oh yeah, that reminds me. Hifumi, weren't you telling me you'd found some evidence?
Really? What kind of evidence?
Actually, you know, now that I'm thinking about it here calmly, it might not be all that relevant.
Share it anyway, please.
Jeez, does your confidence just get up and walk away? It's fine, man. Just tell us.
Please.
If you really insist, then... here it is.
Hmm? What do you have there?
It's an e-handbook?
It happens to be an e-handbook. I found it laying on the ground, so I scooped it up.
Whose is it, or is it also broken? Oh, geez. Well, it's either Mondo's or Chihiro's. It's Chihiro's? Huh, whose is it? Chihiro's hasn't been found. So...
I got it!
I guess?
We know Chihiro's handbook was missing from the scene of the crime, right?
Right.
For a fact.
For a fact indeed. I was totally sure I'd found it.
Then it must hold some clue about the culprit, right?
Well, that's what I was hoping. But it's busted. It won't even turn on.
That's two broken notebooks. Notebooks that Monokuma claims are the next thing to indestructible.
I imagine the culprit broke it to get rid of any evidence after the murder.
How can they be broken, though? Monokuma said they had one weak point. But how could they have broken it?
That's odd. I didn't think the handbooks were quite so fragile.
They're not, according to Monokuma.
You're right. They're not. They're totally waterproof and shock-resistant. It would take an awful lot to break one.
Yeah, you said that those baseballs couldn't have broken Leon's.
And yet, this one does appear to be broken, as is Leon's, sitting useless in the main hall. For all your confidence, that is a remarkably high failure rate.
Do you think there might be some kind of mystery in there somewhere? How precisely did the handbooks get broken?
How did the handbook break? There's only one possible explanation. Yeah. I mean, it has to be a weak point.
I got it!
You already told us before that the handbook has one weak point, didn't you?
He did, when he was assuring us that Leon's couldn't be broken.
Yeah! You remember that?
Uh-huh.
Sure, maybe I let that slip, but I never told anyone what the weak point actually was.
That doesn't mean that they couldn't have discovered it themselves.
But if the handbook is supposed to never break, and two of them broke in quick succession, then...
Then we can only assume that someone's figured out its weakness.
Mm-hmm.
You know what the weakness is, right, Monokuma? So, what is it?
Huh? You're asking me?
Yes, please?
I think it's a necessary piece of information if you want this to be a fair trial.
You go.
But if I tell you, and someone else decides to copy it, that would be very not good.
Just make it against the rules.
Just tell us already! Why would we want to break our own handbooks?
He's saying you might break someone else's.
Oh well, I have a weakness for pushy demands. But you're sure you won't follow their example? Then allow me to make a special announcement. The weak point of my cutting-edge e-handbook is... When it's exposed to high temperatures for too long, it will suffer a meltdown and totally break!
So Mondo took his in the sauna when he was having the contest with Taka. And that's how he discovered how they break. So that's Mondo's broken handbook that's in the mailbox, and he has Leon's.
I flippin' knew it!
You knew it?
Yeah, because I found the handbook laying on the floor of the sauna.
Of course you did.
The temperature in the sauna can reach over 200 degrees. Strange how you don't get burnt, huh?
It's your sweat.
It's because as your sweat evaporates, it creates a cooling layer of air around your skin. If the hot air of the sauna were somehow pushed directly onto your skin, you'd definitely get fried. That layer of air would get blown away
way! That's why you may feel a burning when you move around. So when you're in a sauna, make sure to keep nice and still.
Wow, interesting. I learned one new fact today.
That is a mere trifling speck of knowledge.
Anyway, if you found the victim's handbook in the sauna, then the killer must have been purposely trying to raise its temperature in order to break it.
Meaning the culprit somehow knew its weakness.
But how'd they find out? Monokuma said he didn't tell anyone, right?
It's 'cause they had the sauna contest.
Indeed. Quite the mystery.
What if they found out by accident?
What do you mean by accident?
Like, by wearing all of their clothes into the sauna and it just happened to be in the pocket.
What if the killer took their own handbook into the sauna, not knowing its weakness, and it broke? They'd realize it was broken, of course, and it wouldn't be hard to figure out why. And once they had Chihiro's handbook, they knew they had an easy way to dispose of it.
I won't say it's not possible, but who would have done something like that? I don't know of anyone who took their handbook into the sauna.
Well, we do.
I might know someone who did.
Whoa, seriously?
By the way, sorry if I sound a little dejected. I'm just really disappointed that Mondo killed Chihiro. Both for the loss of Chihiro and because Mondo was actually an interesting character.
I think the one who may have taken their handbook into the sauna was...
Who might have brought their handbook into the sauna? It had to be the one who wore all their clothes into the sauna. It was... Let's try to pick the right direction this time. Though I probably will get it wrong. Yep, I did. So we're taking the long way. Oh, there you are.
Here's my answer. Mondo, your handbook got broken in the sauna, didn't it?
Mm-hmm.
What? Why? Why do you keep accusing him?
Because that's where the evidence points.
Mondo and Taka had an endurance contest in the sauna not too long ago, remember? And for the contest, Mondo just so happened to keep his school uniform on.
He did indeed.
But little did he realize, he'd also left his handbook in one of his uniform pockets. And when it was all over, Mondo discovered that taking your handbook into the sauna could easily destroy it.
No, wait, hold on. You've got it all wrong. He would never kill.
And yet he did.
I don't accept this. Show me the proof. The actual solid proof.
This is the actual solid proof. I mean, I don't want to believe it either, but I found something that proves it beyond a shadow of a doubt. The broken e-handbook, right?
Let's test Makoto's assertion. If what he says is correct, then Mondo, you broke your own
handbook.
It's
not letting me change.
In other words, if Mondo's handbook is actually broken, then that proves that what Makoto said is...
Yeah, it's bringing up the selection when I use the mouse wheel, but it's not letting me actually change.
Well, my goddamn handbook works just fine.
No.
See? Look! Makoto was wrong after all.
I can't...
Mondo wouldn't hurt a fly!
Am I gonna have to switch controls?
Let's test Makoto's assertion. If what there. He says is correct, then Mondo, you broke your own handbook.
In other words, if Mondo's handbook
there, I got it.
Is
finally.
Actually broken,
jeez.
then that proves that what Makoto said is right.
Well, my goddamn handbook works just fine.
Prove it. Show us.
No, that's wrong.
If it's your name in it, then that's fine. If it's Leon's, then you're lying.
Mondo, the handbook you have right now, is it really yours?
The fuck is that supposed to mean?
Just show us the name.
The broken handbook that was in the main hall. Isn't that one actually yours?
What the heck are you talking about?
What I mean is, I think Mondo swapped his handbook out for one that actually works.
He would have to, right?
I think he took Leon's handbook and replaced it with his own. After all, Monokuma said himself that Leon's handbook never should have broken.
That's right! The punishment it suffered wasn't nearly enough to destroy it.
So then, the broken handbook in the main hall is actually Mondo's. Which would mean that the handbook Mondo has right now is actually Leon's, yes?
Yes.
But doesn't that violate the school regulation that says loaning out your handbook is prohibited?
We've already been over this.
Well, here's how I look at it. There is a rule about loaning your handbook to another student, but if they're dead, they're not a student. It's kind of a gray area, I admit. But no worries. If anything, it just makes things more interesting. As such, I decree that exchanging handbooks with a corpse is not a violation of the rules.
Is stealing someone's handbook a violation of the rules?
Well, Mondo, if I'm wrong about this, you're welcome to say so. I'm happy to admit I made a mistake, but...
Son of a bitch!
Yeah, he can't.
What's wrong, bro? Come on! Tell him he's wrong! You are wrong! You have to be wrong! Everything you just said is wrong! You made it all up!
Okay, then why don't we look back on this case one more time?
I'm sorry, Taka, it's not.
That way, everything will become clear. And we'll all see if I was right or wrong.
Oh yeah, this thing. Okay. Alright, packing up. Come across Celeste. Celeste mentions the jacket? Yeah. So she stuffs it in. Then up here, going inside. That's the wrong color sleeve, though, I think. Well, we'll see, won't we? And then... I guess Mondo was in there, working out. Says hi. Then... Or maybe the dumbbell curling goes there. Yeah, I think so. I think this is what goes back in the other place. Yeah. She's going in. Then... He's got the dumbbell. Sneaking up. Splat. Ah, the splatter on the poster. Then drop the dumbbell and he's kind of upset with himself, I guess? Maybe it was a spur of the moment thing? Okay, Chihiro's gone. He's changing the rug. Changing the poster? Picking up Chihiro's body? Why would it be poster Chihiro's body and then poster again? Maybe it is? I'm not certain about that. Then he's got... Oh no, this is what it is. This is what it is. He can't get in.
So he grabs one from the mailbox to get in.
And then the poster? Then Chihiro on the rug, exhausted, everything switched. In comes Byakuya and sees. For some silly reason, he decides to rearrange everything. Let's see. Gets the extension cord, ties Chihiro up. Writes Bloodlust. Then to the sauna. Throws in Chihiro's handbook. And I'm sure I've got something wrong here.
Here's exactly what
there's
happened.
So much to this, and it's
first,
unclear a lot of times.
Let's take a look back to before the incident. Last night, Celeste saw Chihiro in the warehouse, correct? At the time, she was apparently stuffing something into a duffel bag. That something was a blue tracksuit. You can confirm this, right, Celeste? With bag in hand, Chihiro headed out, even though it was officially nighttime. She made her way to the locker room, specifically the boys' locker room. But how could the victim, who is apparently a girl, access the boys' locker room? Simple, because she was really a he, which is why he was able to use his own e-handbook to gain entrance to the boys' locker room. Once inside, he met with someone there. And the person he met was the one who killed him. It seems likely that the killer grabbed the nearby dumbbell, approached the unsuspecting Chihiro, and attacked him.
Well, we're correct so far.
And that's where the bloodstains on the poster and carpeting in the boys' locker room came from. It was likely in the heat of the moment. The body was arranged, but the murder itself felt unplanned. Which is why the killer hurried to try and hide the act. First, pulling up the bloodstained carpet. Then, removing the bloody poster.
Okay. All right. Well, I'm going to save really quickly in case I get this wrong too many times and lose all of my hearts. I don't want to have to go through this whole trial again. I can't save. Great. This, I guess?
The killer is you!
which is why the killer hurried to try and hide the act. First, pulling up the bloodstained carpet. Then, removing the bloody poster.
Okay, good.
And finally carrying the corpse into the girls' locker room. A girl's handbook was necessary to get into the locker room, of course.
Right.
But this alone doesn't prove that the killer was necessarily a girl.
Right. Yeah. Goes and gets a girl's handbook from the mailbox.
After all, Sayaka and Junko's handbooks had been placed in the main hall. Using one of those, a boy could get into the girls' locker room without much problem. And that's exactly how the killer did it. With the carpet and the poster they brought with them, they got to work. They changed the layout of the boys' and girls' locker room in what you might call a crime scene switch. That could have been the end of things, but no. Byakuya discovered the body and decided to intervene in the situation, making things even more complicated.
Which means that Mondo must have left the girls' locker room door open after the fact?
So, after stumbling on the crime scene, he went and grabbed the extension cord from the library, and then he got to work. He used the cord to string up Chihiro's lifeless body. Then, using the victim's own blood, he left a grisly message there at the scene of the crime. He wanted to create the illusion that Genocide Jack was responsible for the slaughter.
Which still blows my mind.
And around the same time that Byakuya was putting together this facade, the killer, having already disposed of Chihiro's bag and other belongings, arrived at the sauna. There, they planned to destroy the last piece of evidence, Chihiro's handbook.
Okay. So it's not this. It's not this. So does this mean just opening the door?
Here's exactly what happened. And around the same time that Byakuya, the killer, having already disposed there, they planned to destroy the...
No. Darn it, I'm losing hearts. Oh, just... It hit the ground. Okay. All right.
The killer is you! And around the same time that Byakuya was putting to the killer, there... And just as the killer expected, the steamy sauna was enough to ruin the electronic gadget.
Right.
Somehow, the killer knew that the handbook couldn't stand up to the heat of the sauna. And the reason they knew that is because the sauna had already wrecked their own handbook. And that's how it all played out. Isn't that right, Mondo Arata?
Yes, it is.
Dun, 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 dun.